Welcome to Simple Engineering, Engineering Simplified. I am Dr. Neetu P.S. Today we are going to discuss about biphase full wave rectifiers. If you are new to this channel, please consider subscribing. Let's move to the video. What are full wave rectifiers? So we have seen half wave rectifier circuit that is inefficient because the conduction takes place only on the alternative half cycles. In the positive half cycle, one diode will conduct, and in the negative half cycle, another diode will conduct. So a better rectifier arrangement would make use of both the positive and negative half cycles. So full wave rectifier offer a considerable improvement over their half wave counterparts. So they are not only more efficient, but they are significantly less demanding in terms of the reservoir and smoothing components. So there are two forms of full wave rectifiers, that is biphase type and bridge rectifier. So today in the section we are discussing about biphase full wave rectifier. So this is the circuit diagram for biphase full wave rectifier. You can see that this is your auto transformer. 240 volt supply voltage we are giving over here. You have two diodes D1 and D2 and an output resistance or a load resistance, that is RL. So in the positive half cycle, what happens is the diode D1 will be conducting and the current flow will be from positive. It will pass through the diode and through the load resistance and it will come back over here. So in this loop it will be the current flow. So at that time the diode D2 is not conducting. Then in the negative half cycle, this will be negative, positive, negative and positive. So what happens is diode D1 is not conducting and D2 will be conducting. So current will flow from positive through this diode D2. Then it will flow through this RL load resistance and then it will come back to the negative. So on the positive half cycle, the point A, that will be positive with respect to the point B. Similarly, point B will be positive with respect to point C. So in the previous figure, you can see that this will be positive and negative. This is positive and negative. So in the negative half cycle, this will be negative, positive, negative and positive. So in the positive half cycle, current flow will be like this. So in this condition, diode D1 will allow conduction and D2 will not be conducting. So D1 conducts on the positive half cycle. On the negative half cycle, D1 will not be conducting and only D1 will be conducting. So the current is routed through the load resistance in the same direction on the half cycle and the current is derived alternately from the secondary windings. So the operation of biphase rectifier is shown here. Here you can see that this is the input voltage which we are giving over here in the positive half cycle. At that time diode D1 will be conducting, so you will be getting D1 will be conducting and current flow will be over here, and this what we are giving in the primary, in the secondary you will be getting the positive half cycle. So in the negative half cycle, diode D2 will be conducting and you are getting the half cycle over here. So positive, negative half cycle, positive half cycle, point A will be positive and B will be negative. And here also point C will be negative. So diode D1 will be forward biased. So current will flow through that diode D1 and D2 is reverse biased. So this will be like open circuited. And diode D1, this will be like closed circuit. So you can see that as this is open circuit, during positive half cycle, A will be positive and B will be negative. So diode D1 will be forward biased. This will act as a closed circuit and current flow will be like this. So you have output across your load resistance RL, that is your VL, load voltage which you are getting over here. So the direction of the current is flown through the arrows, shown in the arrows. So it will be a closed path from A to B. And across your RL load resistance, you can see that you will be getting an output voltage V out. Then next is in the negative half cycle. So positive half cycle is over. Next is negative half cycle. You can see that in the figure, A, the point A is negative and B is positive, and the point C will be positive. So what happens is the diode D1 will be reverse biased and D2 will be forward biased. So when it is forward biased, it will act as a closed circuit over there, and when it is reverse biased, that diode D1, there it is an open circuit. So the flow of the current path is shown here. So it will start from C, the positive. It will flow like this up to this point, then it will pass through the load resistance, then it will come to the point B and then to the C. So this will be like a closed path. So you can see that in the V out, output voltage across the RL, you will be getting an output. So it is like positive half cycle, one diode will start conducting, and in the negative half cycle another diode will be conducting. So we can see the waveforms of biphase rectifier. So in the positive half cycle, V in is the input voltage which we have given. In that case, in the positive half cycle, diode D1 is forward biased and D2 is reverse biased. So across your output voltage or across the load, you will be getting VL. In the negative half cycle, diode D2 is forward biased and D1 is reverse biased. So again, you will be getting output voltage across your load resistance. So this will be continuing for the next positive half cycle, negative half cycle, like that. So you will be getting the pulsating output voltage over here. So that is what we have explained over here about the biphase rectifier. And here the switching action of two diodes that result in the pulsating output, which we have seen in the figure across your load resistance. So unlike this half wave circuit, the pulses of voltage across RL will occur at a frequency of 100 megahertz. It is not 50 hertz, it is 100 hertz. This doubling of ripple frequency allows us to use smaller values of reservoir and smoothing capacitor to obtain the same degree of ripple reduction. And the peak voltage produced by each of the secondary winding will approximately 17 volt, and the peak voltage across your load resistance will be 16.3, that is the 17 volt minus the drop across the diode, that is 0.7 volt. So you will be getting 16.3 volt across your RL, that is the peak voltage. So next is biphase full wave rectifier with, that is this biphase, what we have seen. To that we are connecting a reservoir circuit for the capacitor C1. It can be connected to ensure that the output voltage remains at or near the peak voltage even when the diodes are not conducting. So the capacitor charges to peak value of 16.3 volt in the positive half cycle and holds that voltage at this level when the diodes are not conducting. So the time required by this capacitance C1 to charge to the maximum peak level, that is determined by the charging circuit time constant. So the series resistance in this circuit, that is in this secondary winding resistance, and the forward resistance of the diode, and the minimal resistance of the wiring and the connections. So C1, that reservoir capacitor, it charges very rapidly as soon as either D1 or D2 starts conducting. And the time required for that C1 to discharge is in contrast, that must be very larger. So the discharge time is equal to the product of the capacitance value and the RL. So RL is very large and greater than the secondary winding. So the capacitance takes longer time to discharge. So during this stage, this diode D1 and D2, that will be reverse biased and it held in the non-conducting state. So the only discharge path for this capacitance C1 is through this load resistance RL. This is the voltage waveform for the full wave rectifier. So we have two diodes D1 and D2. Then a reservoir capacitor C1 is connected. So you can see that the secondary voltage will be between, that is 17 volt we are getting, but there will be a voltage drop across the diode, so it will be 16.3 volt. So this is your secondary voltage, and when we have applied, we have seen across the pulsating waveform, that is the voltage across RL without the capacitance C1, we can see that it will be getting like this, 16.3 volt. Then once the smoothing capacitor or the reservoir capacitor is connected, the capacitor starts charging and discharging. So the voltage across RL with the capacitance will be like this. So there will be a ripple over here. So hope this is clear for everyone. If you find this useful, please share it with others. Thank you.